In this video, I will provide instructions to editors on how to manage a discussion using the discussion forum feature in Editorial Manager. For instructions on initiating a discussion, please watch the initiating a discussion video. The discussion forum feature enables editors to solicit informal opinions or feedback regarding a submission from other editors without changing the formal workflow responsibilities. Inviting an editor to a discussion also gives the invited editor access to view the submission PDF as well as any reviews and comments if they did not already have permission to do so. Please note, discussions are not anonymous. All participants in the discussion can see the names and corresponding comments of the other participants. There are two levels of permission possible for managing discussions: permission to manage only discussions you initiated, and permission to manage any discussion. Editors with either of these permissions can add participants to a discussion, edit the discussion topic, as well as close or reopen the discussion. If you feel you should have one of these permissions and do not, please contact your general manager or other support contact for assistance. You can access discussions in progress from your main menu by clicking the submissions with active discussions link in your editor to-do list. The number of active discussions that you have initiated or were invited is indicated in the parentheses. The number of unread discussion points within those discussions, if any, will appear in a blue circle. From the action column of the targeted submission, click discussions to open the discussions pop-up window, which will display all the discussions initiated for the submission. From here, click view to go to the individual discussion page. Alternatively, you can click a specific topic under the topic column to directly open that discussion only. On the discussion page, you can post your own comments by entering comments in the comments field and clicking post. New comments will appear below previous comments in the discussion table. The table may be adjusted to sort comments by participant and or date. Note, all comments posted within the discussion are visible to all participants in the discussion. To add more participants to the discussion, click Add Participants button. This will bring up the same table for selecting participants as used when the discussion was initiated. To open all comments in a separate window for easy viewing or printing, click View Print All option. If there are multiple participants and you want to send an ad hoc message to an individual participant, click Send Email. This allows you to communicate with one individual person rather than the whole discussion group. Permission to edit the discussion topic varies per journal. However, should you edit the topic, be sure to click Save and Close before closing the window to save changes. Once you have received sufficient comments, you can conclude the discussion by clicking Conclude Discussion button. When the discussion is closed, the submission is no longer found in the Submissions with Active Discussion folder. Editors who could view the submission only because they were invited to the discussion will no longer see the submission. And editors who could view the submission because of their permissions or relationship to the submission will still be able to see the closed discussion by clicking the discussion option from the action column of the targeted submission. Editors with permission may reopen a discussion by first clicking view to view the closed discussion, then clicking the reopen discussion button. This is how you can manage a discussion using Editorial Manager's discussion forum feature. Please visit the Journal Article Publishing Support Center should you require more information. Thank you for watching.